Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms. Occasionally we get some mail, frequently get some mail, asking questions about this or that. And this is a good letter. Ted from Baltimore wrote, and it brings to mind that even though we're not actively gardening outside, really, it's too cold.
Right.
But we have to start thinking about that.
Absolutely. Yeah. And Ken talks about pumpkins. He says he wants to plant pumpkins this year. It says on the seed packet to plant manure with the seeds. Can you use chick manure? If not, does anyone out there sell dried manure? Well, we all sell dried manure. We sell chicken manure, sheep manure, any manure you can think of.
It's all available. It depends on your degree of tolerance.
Exactly right. You want to make sure if you're getting it fresh from the cow or fresh from the sheep that it's aged a year. So if you're going out to a farmer and just picking up a pickup
like a mulch pile, it has to age out.
It has to age a good bit of time. By the time it's in bags here, sometimes it's already dehydrated. Sometimes it's just composted and you're getting exactly what you would get if you waited a year after the cow did his stuff, whatever. But manure is great as a soil amendment. It's not necessarily
it's not
a great
the whole
fertilizer.
Thing.
Right. Yeah. Now, once you get a garden established, you probably can use manures, and you use enough of them, you have some good rich soil that you're okay. But the first few years are sometimes in potted plants. You might want to go to other forms of fertilizer that are a little higher in the nutrients.
All right, so this brings to mind, when you're preparing and planning for your garden this spring, you want a manure is not the whole diet that you want. So you have to start thinking when you're planning about getting all of those various nutrients that you're looking for.
And you might have various nutrients for different plants. So back here we have a lawn fertilizer. Now what Marilyn has asked us to do lately is to go in low phosphorus. So this is nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium.
And it zeroes out on the phosphorus.
Phosphorus is usually for root growth and reproductive growth, so fruit growth. Lawns don't really need all that. They want leaf growth, so that's why it's higher than the front number. But the other thing is too much of this in the bay can be harmful.
Right.
So we want to keep especially the phosphorus out of areas where we're doing a whole lot of fertilizer.
Lawns are large areas that are opened up, and you do get some erosion off that. So a low phosphorus fertilizer for the lawn is a good idea.
It is. And now a lot of these other fertilizers, things like Plantone, they're very low. This is a 5-3-3. This is a good all-around plant food. Mm-hmm. It's an organic. It takes a while to break down in the soil, so it's usually going to last you about 8 weeks or so in the soil. Mm-hmm. But it's a good way to not just feed the plant, but it also feeds the soil. Some other guys are kind of faster acting, and I think we all know Miracle-Gro. And this is great for containers or someplace where you can leach out the soil relatively often.
Right. You water it every third day or whatever it is, and pretty soon what you put in there is washed through.
It's washed right out again.
So 20-20-20, those are pretty high concentrations.
But it hasn't been mixed with water yet, so you do mix this like a tablespoon per gallon,
okay,
so that's a concentrate. Now, they also make a plant food spike, and I just want to, these are great used properly. Too often I see people come in with potted plants, and these spikes are right up next to the stem of the plant. Back them away, put them towards the outside of the pot, and they're good. But if you take them too close,
it could burn the roots or something.
It burns the roots. It's all salt, so it's like pouring salt on a plant. It's just no good. But again, there's very specific. This is a citrus food. This is a fruit and berry food. There's cactus food and African violet food and orchid food. There's things like Osmocote. This to me is like my default food. I'll go out and spread this out. It breaks down at 70 degrees over a 4-month period. So
it's
if I don't get out
time
there,
release, capsule kind of thing.
So it's easy to use, so I like using that a lot. But just all sorts of stuff. And then I like a lot of the liquid foods, too, like Monty's Joy Juice, because you just really
They're kind of like Miracle-Gro, though, right? They really are kind of an intense thing, more for a potted plant than general garden use out in the garden.
Yes and no. This, again, the concentration is high here, but you're only using a teaspoon per gallon.
Yeah.
So it really does, you don't have the salts and everything, and it's also organically based. So every fertilizer is a little bit different. Get to know it. Like food, read the label, so you know exactly what
I guess that's what's important. On any one of these packages, there's a lot of information about what this does and how it works. So you really need to read the label so that you're using the appropriate thing for the appropriate plant. And some of these, as you mentioned, are plant specific.
And the other thing is, I mean, you can have too much of a good thing. So if it says a teaspoon, go a teaspoon or less. Don't go more than that. Be really careful not to overdo it.
Okay. Some good tips to think about your garden or even your house plants this time of year. But do some planning, because come March and April, it's time to get back out there.
That's right.
And as far as the cold weather is concerned, we can't get there soon enough. Carrie, thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
On your Sunday Gardener, we'll be back next Sunday with more. We'll see you then.
And if you have a gardening question, you can go ahead and send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go to our website, WBALTV.com.